In this video, I will show you how I created this beautiful ocean painting step by step, including sanding. Enjoy! I work on a gesso board measured 50 by 70 centimeters. I get started with my structure paste, which I mix with acrylic black color. Just add a tiny bit. As you can see, I really mix it well with my palette knife. I'm just working from the outside to the middle part. As you can see, I'm wearing nitrile hand gloves to protect myself. Especially the resin will not go through them. So, it's nearly done now and I'm able to get it on the board. As you can see, I covered the sides of the board with masking tape to protect it from color and having it white and clean after we finished. So I apply now the filler or putty to the board by simply putting small blobs on it. Just put it down as you like, where you think you would like to have this sand effect afterwards. You don't really have to think about it, just do it intuitive. Now I will tell you a little secret for getting a great effect. Just take a normal spong and get the rough side down. Then you start to softly dab the filler. So you get a wonderful structure you will see after it's dry. Just a little secret I wanted to tell you. Hope you enjoy. So now I get my crackle paste in silver, which I will mix with a tiny little bit of black acrylic color. The cool thing is, after this crackle paste will be dry, it gets just stunning effects. Takes about 24 hours to dry, but you will see it later. So it's ready now to get it on the board with my palette knife. Therefore, I just cover all the white holes you will see on the board with this mixed paste. Also, I go very soft over the black part. This is because it will show through after it is dry. That's really a genius effect, I can tell you. So please get this paste in a thick consistency to the board, because the crackle effect will be better afterwards. Just remind you, really thick, goes thick over it. Thank you. So let me zoom into it a bit so you can see it more in detail. See? Everything is covered now, and that's how it should look like. Perfect, we can go further on. During the right side is now taking its drying time, you just get some black acrylic color and give it randomly to the board. You can get yourself a paintbrush to apply it to the board by striking the brush back and forth. As I found it was funny to say it wrong, I just kept it. So I'm sorry, sometimes English is not too easy for me, but I do my very, very best, believe me, and I hope you enjoy it still. Well, in this case, I get myself a sponge because I love sponges. It's super easy to get the acrylic color to the board. See? Here, left, right, super easy. And actually, I made the experience that you save color anyhow because you don't need too much color. The brush sucks more of the color, what the sponge doesn't actually. So I leave out the middle part for now as I would like to do something special. I get some fluid acrylic to my sponge and apply it now to the middle part. I'm doing this because later when I apply my resin mixed with a transparent color to this part, it will shine through, which has a great effect. Okay, as you maybe can see, there are some white spots. I will fill them by my fingers with the turquoise color, so it gives the impression of water. By the way, if it's annoying us later, no problem. It will be easy to remove it again, so no worries at all. Done with the first part, yeah! We'll show you in detail now. As you can see on the right side is the putty thing which has to dry now and the other part is the black. The middle part can see, so let's start with the next part. Just another camera impression for you to have a closer look. So you will see tomorrow or in the next part what now looks smooth will be broken up. So the structure is really drying and then it's breaking. Can you spot the black kit we prepared with the sponge? I love this structure. Can you see it? It's really lovely. Thumb up, I like it. The work is done for today. See you. Wow, here you can see the structure which developed after night. I'm really so happy how it turned out, really impressed. So as everything is dried perfectly, we now can start with the white highlights. Therefore, get yourself a Bristol brush or similar. I just use a normal white acrylic color without water. Also, the brush is dry. That's important. add some color to the brush and strip it off, so very less color is on the brush. Then you can begin to dab it softly to the board. See? Just slowly and soft. Because of the structure, the color will be added to it and creates depth. Now we are ready to mix our resin. I use a 1x1 resin, therefore I get myself a bigger cup and some smaller plastic caps. A little hint for me, when the resin is dry, you can reuse the cups. As I'm in this case not covering the whole board with resin, I will just use a lesser amount than calculated. In this case, it will be 400 milliliters mixed resin. I put in 200 milliliters of the resin, and then I add 200 milliliters of the hardener. After that, you have to mix it very well together. Minimum 3 minutes. I suggest really minimum 3 minutes. That's very important. I speed it up a bit, the process. So that's done. Now we get the little cups. I will use 3 of them as I will use 3 colors. I'm working with a pigment for the white color. It's a dry pigment. I use titanium white. I add some of it, as you can see, to the cup and put it aside. Oops, no worries, doesn't matter at all. Now I add some iso alcohol to the white pigment, just some little drops. I'm doing this because the pigment may not dissolve properly to the resin if I give it to it direct, and I want to avoid crumbs. So I mix it well till it's a homogene mass. Now I take my mixed pur resin and share it to the other cups. One cup will be filled in a bit more, as this will get the main color of the ocean painting, and the other will be approximately 3/4 full and a bit to the white. Just getting myself the chopsticks to mix everything well. In this case, I do have a phenomenal turquoise color. The cool stuff is that it changes the color. Means on the black side, it will turn a bit greenish, which I find wonderful. Have you seen how less I put in? Just a peak of color, that's all you need. The second color is indigo blue as an ink version. Also, some drops are enough. Just mixing everything very well. The indigo ink is a bit transparent, so it's not opaque, just a bit more clear. The turquoise shimmers and is a kind of, nearly opaque. Can you see it? I love this color. Okay. So at least I take the white, and this is more fluid because of the alcohol we added. This helps also with the lacing later, you will see. So there are no clumps, nothing at all. It's quite smooth, perfect. I start now with the indigo one. I just randomly applied to the board. See? Just apply it where you want it to be. There are no rules at all. Secondly, we take the turquoise and apply it at the under part of the board. Like in nature, when the sea comes near the beach, it will be more light. Some of the turquoise may also shine through the indigo blue, that's why I'm pouring it between. Let's remove the cups. Just put them on the side. And then we can start mixing both colors together. I love to use my hand for this process. Just feeling the paint makes me really happy. It's a bit like meditation, isn't it? Just try to get the paint carefully to the sides with your hand, gently left and right. Oh my God, look at the turquoise. How it changes the color to a bit of greenish. Oh, I love it. Really do. I'm getting myself some tissue to clean my hands and switch to the spatula. Want to show you how to have the edges clean and stop the resin from running down a bit. Okay. So just go softly down from one side to the other. And if you work careful by wipe off the spatula at the edges, the resin will not run off the sides. Can you see? Just wipe off carefully. Wiping off again. And spread it inside. If you discover some holes, just take some leftover resin from the cups and add it to the painting, as I do here. Also, if you think, oh, okay, here should be some more highlight, add some of the colored resin. Add some accents. Most of the time, there's still enough colored resin in the cups. So this should not be a problem at all. Just play a bit. I mean, we will add some more resin anyhow, so you won't make any failure. Just keep that on your mind. I get now my torch to remove the little bubble which occur. They will go easily. It's important to be quick. Do not stay too long on one part as it can burn the resin, and this will be seen as a blind part later when it's dry. So just near and quick. Now I get my pour transparent resin and pour some of it on the painting, exactly there where I wanted to have the waves afterwards. The advantage of doing this will be after applying the white now, it will be connected with the pour resin and the lacing effect will start. So apply the white now to the resin just a bit before, means not directly on, just a bit before. You are allowed to really apply a high amount of white, so do not be too economical. I now get my heat gun, which is set to the highest level, and blow sideways from below, gently blowing with a lot of feelings. Blow to the seaside. So that's real time I'm doing it, no time lapse. Important, please do not stay too long on one part and overdo it. To get the lacing start, the resin needs a rest. Just let it stay for a minute or so and do the next waves. It will do its thing, but not immediately. Believe me. So for the next waves, I'm taking my white and thinking about where I can place it. A tip. It's very nice if you place it over a darker part, so it gives the impression of a real wave with its own shadow. So place the white above a darker spot to pretend the shadow, so it looks like there's a shadow. As the beach wave had a rest, I can work on it again a bit. I do not like the top of the waves, it's too frayed for me, so I push it with the heat gun in the beach direction to soften it. For the next waves, I push it from the seaside to the beach side. This has the effect that the wave makes a natural curve. You know what I mean? Also, if you blow the other way up to the seaside, it will imitate the feeling of splashing waves. Can you see it? Up, splashing, down, curved. If you feel unconfident, just try only waves on a separate canvas and push them around. It's all about the experience and trial and error thing. And of course, about your taste, if you like more wild waves or soft wave, it's always up to you. I think just trust yourself. I just make some fine-tuning with the chopstick to the white, like it to be more soft at the end. Just decided to add some more accents to the end part, looking like waves seeing far away. So I'm just putting a bit of white. Just decided to get some more of the turquoise to add it at the land side to pretend water puddles. I just rub it in with my hands and my fingers, very soft, everywhere I wanted to see some water puddles. So generally speaking, always watch the painting because resin moves, so just check during the working time, but no stress, just feel it. Thank you. Yeah, the first layer is done. Look how beautiful it turned out. The blue, the white, the lacing part, everything is like I wanted it to be. Also the structure and the waves, all are fine. I'm really, really happy. See the waves? I love them. So now you can wait about 5 to 24 hours to go further on. But good to know, to avoid hairs in your resin painting, always check it carefully and remove the hair or dust with a toothpick. Can you see? And between, you can also remove the bubbles with a torch. So let's start the next part. I'm mixing my resin, in this case just the white and pure resin. The dry pigment is already dissolved with alcohol and I just add the resin to it. You see it's a very small cup. Would you say cuppy in English? Would you? I take the pure resin and pour it under the first beach wave. I would say approximately between 2 to 15 centimeters as a distance. Spread it with a chopstick or you can use your fingers as well and go along the white part, you see? It's a bit of work, isn't it? Doing an ocean painting. It's not all as quick and easy as it looks like. I take my torch and blow the bubbles out again and make the resin a bit warm. Now the white has its turn. I add it below the pure resin and a bit on the pure resin, just like I think it would occur in the nature. Again, no rules, just let it flow. See, the lacing becomes visible. I take my heat gun again and blow the white gently to the seaside, from below to above. Can you see the cells start to build up? Just adding some of the white. So a bit more white on the, like a fine line. Mixing it a bit with the chopstick, you know, giving a massage to the resin. It's done. Yes, we are done. Just see some pictures I did after 24 hours drying time of the resin. It turned out so beautiful in my opinion. Enjoy. So I will add another resin layer to it. But I hope you can see how cool it is already now. I'm so delighted. I love this matte and shiny part. It's so noble. See the different blue shadows with this greenish touch. I love it. You now can see the waves better in the close-up. Can you see it? It gives some impression of real waves, well, for me, indeed. But also this greenish, shiny part, I love it, really, I do. Now we start with the final resin coat. So you need just pure mixed resin. I'm doing this because it looks better and of course smooth. Make sure the painting is level again to avoid that the resin drops down and everything is covered with the same amount. The level check. I'm just cleaning it from the dust and then we can start. As we are within the 24 hours, I do not have to sand the resin painting, as I normally would do, because the new resin, the layer of new resin, has to be a connection or needs a connection to the painting. Also, do not forget to check if there are any dust or hairs on top of the resin, because it's so annoying when the resin is dry and you find them stuck. You have to sand it and do everything again. To avoid this, just cover it afterwards with a big carton or just leave the room and let the resin painting alone. Final touch. I'm taking my flashlight to be able to see everything, every tiny little thing, which I can remove with a toothpick. But it looks good so far. So I'll do the final checkup and touching the edges with my fingers at the white to make it more smooth and wipe it into some areas to pretend a feeling of water petal. Et voilà! I'm happy it's done, but unfortunately there happened a big, big failure and I was a bit frustrated, but I thought I will show you and tell you as I think nobody is perfect. What happened? I mixed too less resin and actually I thought, well, it will be leveled by itself. but unfortunately it did not. What a shame, I tell you. Can you see? Here the spot? That sucks, I tell you. Well, I have to sand it down now and pour a new resin layer on it to have it clean and pretty again. The good thing is, I may show you now the sanding process. Please always wear a mask during this process. I use a 80 grit sanding paper. So let's start. And always remember, if something happens with your resin painting, no worries at all. Just sand it down and go over it with a new layer of resin. So that's always how you can save your painting. After the sanding part, you have to carefully clean it because of the dust particles on it. You may do this with a sponge and dishwash water. Make sure everything is removed. I love to see this process when the resin touches the matte part and it becomes shiny and clear again. See? It's so stunning. The underground is crystal clear again. Here a little slow motion. It's just amazing, isn't it? Magic occurs. I gave all of my resin to the painting again and it now just has to dry. I controlled everything and hopefully now added enough resin to it. Joking, of course I did. The only thing I changed, I have added some little white details at the end. Can you see? Just included a tiny part of white mixed resin and added it with the joystick. Now it's done and looks perfect. I'm really happy how it turned out. That's how it could look at your wall. Just amazing, isn't it? I hope you enjoyed this video and you may picked up some helpful tips. If you did, I would be so happy when you give me your like and a positive comment and subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much. Big kisses, Andrea.